Hi, this is Don, and I thought I would take a couple of minutes and show you how I would set up a spreadsheet to calculate the MAD, the MSE, the RMSE, and the MAPE. And this is really pretty straightforward to do if you take the time to set your spreadsheet up and think about the formulas. And let's look at those first of all. The MAD, or the mean absolute deviation, is the sum, this is summation symbol, of the time from period 1 to period n of the absolute value, that's those bars, of the actual at time period t minus the forecast at time period t. And then we take that sum and divide it by the number of periods n. For the mean square error, it's similar. We're taking this error, the absolute minus the forecast at a time period t, squaring it, summing up those squares, and then dividing that by n. That's where we get the mean. For the root mean square error, is very easy. Once we get the mean square error, we just take the square root of it. For the MAPE, the mean absolute percentage error, again, we're taking a summation from time period 1 to time period n of the difference between the actual at time period n minus the forecast divided by the actual, and then we're taking the absolute value of that. Again, we sum those up, divide by the number of periods, and multiply that times 100. Okay, let's look at how I set the spreadsheet up. The first three columns are just our data. And I've got the period, the actual value for time period t, and the forecast for time period t. And again, I've just made up these values so I'd have a list of actual values and a forecast value. And you can get the forecast, of course, from a moving average or exponential smoothing or whatever forecast method you come up with. But once you have those, then we can take that data to calculate the MAD, the MSE, the RMSE, and the MAPE. The first column is labeled error, and that is nothing more than the actual A sub T minus F sub T. And if I can get this to work, I'm going to click on that first cell, double click, and then it will show the formula B6, which is the actual value, minus C6, which is the forecast value. And that gives us our error term for the first period. And once we get that formula, the quickest way to do it, of course, is just drag it down, get the plus sign, and drag down to copy that formula all the way down. The next column is the absolute value of that error. And I'm just taking the error and taking the absolute value of that. So I'm going to click on the cell, double click, to show you the formula. And I'm taking the absolute value of the error, which is the B6 minus C6, taking the ABS function, which is the absolute value. And again, copying that down. The next column is the square of the error. And again, this is pretty straightforward. I'm going to click on this cell. And you can see that we're just taking the error, which is in column D, and then we're raising it to the second power, squaring it. And of course, drag that formula down. The last column is the absolute value of the errors divided by the actual value. And that's shown here in this formula, the actual minus the forecast divided by the actual, and then we're taking the absolute value of that. So I'm going to click on this cell, double click to show the formula. And again, we've got the actual minus the forecast divided by the actual, and then we take the absolute value of that whole thing. That's the reason for the double parentheses there. And of course, copy that down. I then calculate my totals, and I just use the sum function. sum of everything in that column. And then I just copied that formula across the four rows to get the sums for each of the four columns. N, pretty straightforward when you only have an N of 12, but if you've got a long column with data, sometimes it's tedious to count those. So you can use the count function. C-O-U-N-T, parentheses, and then the range of the data, parentheses close, and that gives you the count, in this case 12, of the periods. Now let's look at MAD. And I'm going to double click there. And you can see that we're just taking our summation of the absolute value of the errors and dividing that by the number of periods to get the mean, a 0.383. For the mean square error, again, same basic formula. I'm taking the sum of the square of the errors, that's just the error term squared, summing up those 12 values and dividing by 12 to get the mean. Root mean square error, just the square root of the mean square error using the square root function. And then the MAPE, again, I'm taking the sum of the absolute values of the actual minus the forecast divided by the actual, again, taking the absolute value of that, summing up those 12 values and dividing by N. And really, that's how I would set the spreadsheet up. If you've got multiple things that you need to calculate the MAPE and the MSE and the RMSE for, just replicate this basic spreadsheet and then put in the forecasts and the actuals, and then you can crunch these numbers out. Again, use the power of Excel.